Hello everybody, welcome to this instruction video. In this video I'd like to show you part 5 of the crochet along peacock tail bag designed by Tatiana from Lilla Bjorn Crochet. For this video I'm using linen soft yarn by Scheepjes. This is the same yarn that comes in the kits that goes with this crochet along in combination with a 3mm crochet hook. For this part I'll be showing you the front side of the bag. And that's this last edge here, that's for part 5. In a separate video I'll show you how to do the back side of the bag. So for this video, the front, and then we'll be doing the last details for this pattern before we can actually join the two together. I want to thank you for watching. I hope it's a useful video for you. When you've completed the front and back of the bag, check for gauge that they should be approximately the same size. A little bit difference isn't a problem, you can correct that with blocking. But as such, you want your two parts to be approximately the same size. What you should also check for is that your size at this point should be, if you use the linen soft yarn, should be about 29 centimeters at its widest point here. If so, you're perfect. If there's a big difference between your two sides, either change a hook size or see if you can catch that with blocking your pieces. Because this hasn't been blocked yet, you can see it's still curling inward. So once blocked, this will also straighten out. So check your gauge and check that your two sides are the same size. Row 26. New color yarn, and this time we do not start with a slip knot on our hook. I've marked the first stitch. The reason I've done this is so that I can find it easily when we need it later on, because at the moment we're not going to start in the first stitch but actually in the 18th stitch. That's this one here. So count 18 stitches, and then in this stitch here you're going to attach your yarn with a slip stitch. Do a chain one. This does not count as a stitch, it's just to get you to a good working height. Now we're ready to start the first stitches. We start with doing 5 single crochets. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. There we go. 5 single crochets. You'll notice I've taken the thread with me here and I'm working it in. Now we're doing half doubles on the next 4 stitches, and then we're ready to start the repeat unit. It's 1, 2, 3, and number 4. Number 4 is in your this treble cluster here. That's number 4. Now we're ready to start the repeat unit. You're going to work the repeat unit starts by working a front post treble 2 together, and you're going to work it around the 2 posts here. These 2 front posts, you're going to work a front post treble 2 together around. And we're going to work first this one and then that one. So for me it's the right handed one. If you're left handed it'll be the other way around, of course. So it's twice over for the treble, folding my work ever so slightly back, hook around that first post and start taking off 2 loops. Now we're doing the same on the other side, so it's going to be on this one here, again twice over, into that treble, and take off 2 loops. Take off 2 loops, 3 loops on your hook, take them all off. And there we go. If you find that these stitches pull too much, you could consider working a front post double treble two together here. We're not going to skip any stitches, so immediately on the next stitch, we've just got this thread in the way here, so immediately on the next stitch I'm going to work a half double. That's going to be the first of 16. You see I'm working immediately on the next stitch, first of 16. That's 1, 2, 3, and then that is your repeat units that you're going to do 5 times. Work 16 half doubles. 15 and number 16. Number 16 is again in this cluster stitch, this that you've worked here. And that is your repeat unit. If you're going to do again a treble, front post treble two together around these two stitches here, then do not skip any stitches, but continue on your next stitch and work 16 half doubles. Going to do 5 of these in total. I've just done 1, so you need to do 4 more. I've now done the repeat 5 times, so you see it everywhere over here. So now we still need to do 1 more front post treble 2 together on these last 2 here before doing a few last stitches. We're again not going to work till the end, so we're going to stop here somewhere. So the last front post treble two together, and if you find that front post double treble is better for you, then do that. So 1, and then on the other side, 2, and take them all off. Oh, sorry. Do not skip any stitches to the back. So immediately in the next stitch, it's going to be that one there, work 3 half doubles. It's 1, 2, 3 half doubles, and work 5 single crochets. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Let's do a slip stitch on the next stitch, and then that completes this round. You can now cut your yarn and open up this stitch and work away your yarn tail. Row 27. Going to start in the 5th stitch after the chain 1. So here's the chain 1, and then go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in this stitch, attach your yarn with a slip stitch. Starting with a chain 1, work a single crochet in the next 4 stitches. 1, 2, 3, and 4 on the next, so on these 4 stitches. 4 single crochets, work 1 half double, so now we're ready to start the repeat units. Start by working 4 half doubles. So 1, 2, 3, and 4 half doubles, like so. Now we're going to come down and work a treble 4 together in the 4th half double of row 25. So remember, you're now on 27, so 25 is, for me, is the pink here. I'm going to work that in the fourth half double. And remember, you've got a half double underneath here also. So see that that's 1, 2, 3, 4. So around that stitch there. So don't accidentally, if you have this stitch over here, you'd miss that one and go 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you'll want too far. So you want to make sure you're also counting that one. So in the fourth half double, and we're doing it exactly as we've always done. So that's twice over for the half double. Then 1, 2, 3, 4. So around this stitch here. Then take off two loops, take off two loops. And then the other three legs, you're working in that space to the bottom of the stitch. I mean, you've done this many times before, so this should be familiar to you. And that's the second leg and the third leg in that stitch. Like so. Four loops. Four legs, five loops on your hook, take them all off. That is your first treble four together for this repeat made. I'm going to skip a stitch to the back. See how I'm skipping that stitch there? Take the thread with me and then work one half double. That's the first of three. So 1, 2, 3 half doubles. If you want, you can fashion that bobble there a little bit. We're now again going to work a treble four together, and we're going to work it in the front post double treble you have down here. So that's, for me, that's the pink one here. You're going to work it around there. You're going to work again a front post treble four together. So that's the first leg. And then the next three are again in the bottom of that stitch. I might be going slightly faster now than I've done before, but I know that you know exactly how to do this stitch by now. And again. Like so. Five loops on your hook. Take them all off. And there we go. You're going to skip a stitch to the back. So see how I'm skipping that stitch there. Work in the next. Again, three half doubles. 2 and 3 half doubles. We're now again working a front post, sorry, a treble four together around the post from row 25, and again it's the fourth half double, and this time you see that's the that's your starting point, because that's the front post treble. Then you count 1, 2, 3, 4. So you want this one here. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4. That one. Twice over. And then around that post, you do the first leg, and then again, three more legs in the base of the stitch. So, oops, it's 1, 2, and 3. In four loops on your hook, take them all off. There we go. Skipping a stitch to the back, skipping a stitch, work four half doubles. It's 1, 2, 3, and 4. And that is your repeat unit. You're going to be doing a lot of these bobbles here. You're going to do this four more times, five times in total. So now you're going to again start with doing four half doubles and then a treble four together. So everything I've just done, do this four more times, and then I'll just show you the last few stitches. When you've done the repeat 5 times, you have a few stitches left. You're going to work 5 single crochets on the next stitches. 2, 3. That went all wrong. Let me do that again. Just going to work those last 2 again. This one, then this is number 2, 3, 4, and 5. Like so. Going to close, finish this round with a slip stitch in the next stitch. You can cut your yarn, open up, and work away your tails. Row 28, new color yarn. We're going to start in the 5th stitch from the chain 1. So here's the chain 1, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And stitch number 5, I'm going to attach yarn with a slip stitch. Chain 1 and work 2 single crochets. So 1 and 2. Now do 3 half doubles. So 1, 2, and 3. Now going to start the repeat unit. We're going to work a treble 2 together on either side of the bobble you have here on row 26. So you've got this blue stitch here and that blue stitch there. Around those 2, going to work a treble 2 together, front post of course. I'm going to do twice over for the treble and then come 2 rows down to that blue half double. In my case it's a blue one. That's to the right of the popcorn. 1, 2. And then the other leg is to the other side of the popcorn. You can see that one there. Like so. And then take them both off, like so. If you go, if you really push your popcorn aside, you will see there's another stitch there, but that's the treble cluster is covering that stitch. You don't want that stitch, you want the stitch next to it. So, like this. I'm going to skip a stitch here to the back. See, I'm skipping that stitch there, and then work 3 half doubles. 1, 2, and 3. And that third one brings you again to the next cluster. Now this here is a mini repeat unit. This this treble 2 together and the 3 half doubles. You're going to do this basically around each and every treble cluster you have here. You're going to be doing this small repeat unit. I'm going to do it 2 more times, so 3 times in total. So also around these 2 here. So let me just, I'll show you them again. It's twice over. And then at this point, see if I do this here, you see that stitch behind. You don't want that one. You want the stitch that's, it's going to be that one there. That's the one you're going for. So don't do this with a popcorn and think, oh, I need that one. No, you need this one knit this one. And of course it's not a popcorn, it's a cluster, but I keep getting mixed up sometimes. And then also on this side here. These two stitches are directly next to one another. And take them off. You can see how you've framed this cluster here. Again, skipping a stitch to the back, work three half doubles. And three, like so. And now we need to do it again, so again around this leg and that leg. Twice over. On this side is the first half of the treble two together, and then twice over on the other side, this one. And take them both off. Skip a stitch to the back and work three half doubles. One, two, and three. That is your mini repeat unit that you've now done three times. On the next stitch, we're going to work an increase. So it's two half doubles in the same stitch, and as a reference this should be above this treble two together that you did here, so that should be aligned. And now work four more half doubles. So one, two, three, and four. Now you've done the entire repeat unit, you need to do this a few more times, four times in total, so I've just done once, you need to do three more. So you're going to do three full repeats more, and then you're going to do three of your mini repeats. So you're going to do this on all of these sections here, and then you're going to do those mini repeats on these last three clusters you have just before the edge. Then I'll see you here just for those last few stitches. When you've done the four full repeats and you've done your mini repeat one more time, you should have a few stitches left. You're going to work two single crochets and a slip stitch. And then you've completed this round also. Just one, two single crochets, and a slip stitch. Row 29. Going to start in the fourth stitch. Here again, the chain one, and it's one, two, three, four. Stitch with a slip stitch. Chain one. And single crochet on the first seven stitches. So one, two, three, four, five, six, and number seven. Seven single crochets, one half double, so, and now we're ready to start the repeat unit. The repeat unit is going to start by doing 14 half doubles. This one, two, three, 12, 13, And then the last one is 14. There we go. Now this should have brought you to your first series of cluster stitches you have here. We're now again going to be making a treble four together cluster, and we're going to be making it around this stitch here that's basically in between your V. So that purple stitch, that post, that we're going to use to make again a treble four together around. Get more yarn, there we go. So again, make a treble four together, so that's twice over. Then around that stitch that's nicely in between those two stitches in the V. That's one, and then of course the other three legs you make at the base of the stitch. That's two. Three and four. And there we go. And take them all off. Going to skip one stitch to the back. So the next stitch we're going to be working in is this treble two together here. If you look there to the back, you see you're skipping a stitch and work two half doubles. There we go. Now we're again going to work a treble cluster around this post here. So exactly the same position between the V's on that purple stitch there. Going to work a treble four together. So one. And then work the next three legs in the stitch again. And two and three. Take them all off. Skip a stitch to the back. So the next stitch, and this one is actually again the first stitch of your next repeat unit. So now you're going to work 14 half doubles again. Everything we've just done, the 14 half doubles, the treble cluster, two stitches, treble cluster. You're going to do this three times in total, so you need to do two more. Then I'll see you for the last bit of this round, because you'll still have a considerable amount of stitches left. And I'll see you for this last part. I've done the repeat three times. At this point you need to work 15 half doubles. I'm again going to skip a stitch, that's of course still part of the repeat unit, and now work 15 half doubles. That's two, three, four, 14, and then the last one, number 15. So that's 15 half doubles, followed by 7 single crochets. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and 7. The last stitch is a slip stitch into the next stitch, and then you're finished for this round. Round 30, you're going to start in stitch number 14. That's the first stitch, is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, number 14. This is a stitch we join with a slip stitch. Chain one, and then we work 4 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, and 4, and also 4 half doubles. 1, 2, 3, and 4. There we go. Now we're going to do a front post treble 2 together around this cluster here. We're going to work it around both of these 2 trebles 2 togethers you already have here, so around those 2 stitches. Twice over, then around the first one, just to the right of the popcorn, the cluster, I mean, work the first part of your front post treble 2 together, then again twice over, and now on the other side of the cluster, around this. So, and then bring them together. And by doing so, you're really framing this cluster here very nicely. I've just got my yarn a little tied here. There we go. So that was the treble 2 together. We're going to skip a stitch and then work a half double on 3 stitches. I'm just going to cut this yarn here, then I can better see what I'm doing. Let's going to skip 1 stitch and go to the next stitch. That's the first of 3. 2 and 3 stitches. And now we're going to do the same. We're again going to frame this cluster here the same way we did there. So again, around that post, 1, 2, so that this one already contains, of course, the leg on that side, so now you're also making a leg towards the other direction, and take them all off, and you can see how you've now framed these 2 clusters here. I'm going to skip a stitch and then we're starting a small repeat that you're going to do 2 times. And that's skipping 1 stitch too many. Skip only 1 stitch and then work 13 half doubles. This is 2, 3, 12, and number 13. Like so. I'm going to turn my work. And now we work again a front post treble 2 together on again these 2 positions here. So this is exactly the same as that, as you've done before. So twice over. So around this first treble 2 together, you make your first leg. And then around the other treble 2 together, you make the second leg. And take them all off. You can see again how you've framed that cluster. Skipping a stitch to the back. Skipping 1 stitch, work 3 half doubles. It's 1, 2, 3. Half doubles, and now you're again also going to frame this cluster stitch here, and again this one already contains that second leg from the previous treble 2 together, so you're just going to have to stack those in front of one another, and then on the other side pick up a leg and take them both off. Like so. Then skipping 1 stitch and work 13 half doubles again. So do this once more Then I'll see you for the last bit. So again, 13 half doubles, and then work here, work the same as there. I've done the repeat again. Still have a few stitches left to the end. Going to skip a stitch to the back, that's of course still part of your repeat unit, and now work 4 half doubles. 2, 3, 4 half doubles, and single crochets on the next 6 stitches. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 single crochets, and of course finish with a slip stitch. Row 31. Going to start in the 5th stitch this time. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Stitch number 5. Attach your yarn with a slip stitch. Chain 1 and then do 3 single crochets. So 1, 2, and 3 single crochets. Half double on the next 2 stitches. So 1 and 2. And now we're going to work treble 4 together. And we're going to work it off on the first of these 2 stitches in the pink from this, from row 29, that are visible. You see that stitch and that, those, so you're going to take that first one there. Go work a treble 4 together around that stitch. And it is just a little tight all in there because you've got these overlay stitches that are just slightly in the way. So you work a treble 4 together as we've done many times before. Leg number 2, 3, and 4. Like so. And take them all off. Going to skip a stitch to the back, and then we're starting our repeat unit. So skipping a stitch to the back. See, I'm skipping that stitch. And this is the first half double of 17. So it was 1, 2, 3, 16, and 17. 17 half doubles, and now we're again going to a cluster exactly the same as that one. So again, on the first of these 2 stitches that are visible, that first one, work a treble 4 together around that stitch. So first leg and then legs 2, 3, and 4. You work in the base of the stitch. It's 1, 2, and 3. And take them all off. Again, skip a stitch to the back. And we're going to then do the repeat unit a second time. So again, 17 half doubles. That was 2. Let me just fashion this a bit. That's 2. So I'm going to do 17. 3, 4, 16, and 17 stitches. So 17 half doubles. Now again a cluster in exactly the same way over here. In the first of those two stitches that's visible, make a treble four together cluster. And then last legs, and this is then also the last cluster that you're working here, and then you've done quite a few of them, so I'm sure you'll have mastered this stitch by now. And take them all off. Skip a stitch to the back and then work two half doubles. Skipping a stitch, work one, two half doubles, and then five single crochets. Just one, two, three, four, five, and a slip stitch. Row 32. I'm going to attach a yarn in the fourth stitch. It's 1, 2, 3, 4. Attach with a slip stitch, chain one, and then work two single crochets. So 1, and two. We're now going to work a front post treble two together either side of the cluster, actually exactly the same way that we've done on two rows down. It's twice over, and then around this treble two together, take your first leg, and you only want to take off two loops. There we go. And also on the other side, do your treble two together. You're going to do it around that treble two together there. Three loops on your hook, taking off in one go. By doing so, you're again framing this little cluster stitch here. Going to skip a stitch, and then there we go, skip one stitch and taking that thread with me, and note you're now going to work 17 single crochets. Don't go autopilot and work half doubles here. You're working single crochets, 17 single crochets, 16, 16 and 17, like so. Number 17 is again in this cluster stitch you have here. Now we're again going to frame this cluster. That's twice over. To the right side, pick up a leg. And also to the left, pick up a leg. Around the front post treble two together you already have from two rows down. And take them all off. Skipping a stitch to the back, going to repeat what we've just done. So again, 17 single crochets. 3, 4, 5, 16, and number 17. 17 is again in your treble four together stitch. We're doing exactly the same as before, again a treble two together around this stitch here, around that cluster stitch. Just picking up the first leg, and on the other side also. Skipping a stitch to the back, skipping one stitch, work a single crochet on two stitches, and then work a slip stitch. Row 33, the last row of this part. Now we're going to start in the first stitch. Remember the stitch that you marked from row 25? That first stitch you're going to start in now. And then we're going to work an edge all along our work till we get to the other side, the stitch that we also marked. I'm going to, this time I have yarn on my hook again with a slip knot. I start with a standing single half double crochet in that first stitch there. The standing half double. Now you can remove the stitch marker. I'm going to continue and work a half double on every stitch. And this color is the same as the last round on the back part color. So if you're not following the colorway in the pattern, make sure that your last round is the color that you're going to use for joining your bag and for the strap, the part that comes here up top. So this is your main color that you're using here. It doesn't matter if you did another colorway on other rows, but here use the color that you have for the main part, your main color. And this is also the same color that you should use for the last row of the back of your bag. So you're working a half double on every stitch. And then I'd just like to show you how to treat these bits here. And I'm almost there. Like so. And one more stitch to go. The next stitch contains a slip stitch and the chain one from joining our yarn. So in that stitch you're also going to work a half double. So just next to that slip stitch you work a half double. Then skip the chain one and in the single crochet, the actual stitch, work a half double again. So you're skipping those chain ones. They do not count as a stitch. And then continue working a half double on each of these single crochets here. And again, in the next to the slip stitch, work a half double, skipping the chain. In the single crochet, you work another half double. And so you continue going all the way around, and every stitch you work a half double. And when you get to a stitch that contains a slip stitch, you make a half double next to it, next to that slip stitch. And this way you're getting a very nice even row of stitches for joining the front and back part of the bag. You want the last row to have the same number of stitches. So the last row of the front and the back, if they have the same number of stitches, that would make life easier for you. Otherwise you can always fudge. Something I do a lot, by the way. I just fudge things if I make mistakes. So continue going all the way around. Work a half double on every stitch. Now just continue, so this edge this way, you're going to continue go all the way up to here and then go all these stitches, and then I'll just see you on this side here for coming back down. I want the top edge to come down to the last stitch here. I've got one more single crochet, that's that stitch there. Going to work a half double on that. And now the next stitch here is your slip stitch. You're going to work a half double next to the slip stitch. in the same stitch. So you're going to have two stitches in there. And then continue again with a half double on every stitch. And when you get to a stitch that contains a slip stitch, you work a half double next to it. So that was the last single crochet, coming down and work a half double next to the slip stitch. See how you're coming down here. I'm going to work my way to the last stitch, work a half double on every stitch. And then you have completed the front part of the bag. Still need to do the back part also, or maybe you've done them the other way around, that's of course also possible. And then we can join the front and back to finish our bag next week. So I'm going to continue just working to the last stitch. We've completed the front and back side of your work. You're ready for next week when we're going to be joining our bag. At this point, you want to check that they are the same size, and you also maybe a good idea to actually block them, because if you look very closely and if I put them exactly on top of one another, you'll see that my front is just ever so slightly smaller than my back side. Now, this isn't a crisis, this I can catch with blocking. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to block the front and the back to the same size. That'll also just get rid of a bit of this this curl that I have here, so I'll also flatten that out. And then we're ready for next week when we're going to be joining these two sides together and actually finishing